C.N.T, stand up! C.N.T, stand up! C.N.T, stand up!
Good night, everyone. Welcome to C.N.T Standout. I'm your host tonight, Deanna Radcliffe, and I am joined by my lovely co-hosts, Kadeen, Jasmine, and Ariel. Before we start, we're going to start with an opening prayer by Jasmine.
Good night, everyone. Dear Heavenly Father, we come before you tonight just asking that you cover everyone here and that you cover everyone watching. And we pray that everyone receives this wonderful word. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Amen. Thank you. Tonight, our topic is going to be deliverance from strongholds, and that's what we're going to be covering throughout this entire month. But first, we're going to go into an activity that's going to be called Fill in That Scripture. Basically, one of the co-hosts is going to read out a scripture with blanks, and then you're going to have to figure out the blanks and where they're taken from.
So I'm going to read the first one, but before I read it, you have 20 seconds to get it right. And don't forget, if you know it, put it in the comments below. Okay, so the first one is, if the blank therefore shall make you blank, ye shall be blank indeed. You know it. Few seconds left. Don't forget to comment below. All right. It's going to be taken from John 8, verse 36. So the whole scripture is, if the Son therefore shall make you free, you shall be free indeed.
The next scripture, the blank is my light and my blank. Whom shall I blank? Do you know it? I think you got it. Comment down below.
10 seconds left.
All right. The scripture is Psalms 27, verse 1. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear?
Ooh, that's a good one. All right, our next and our last scripture is, fear thou not, for I am with blank. Be not dismayed, for I am thy God. I will blank thee, yea, I will help thee. Yea, I will blank thee with the right hand of my righteousness. This is a long one, so probably should give you a few more seconds. Guess this one.
Don't forget to comment if you know it.
Did you get it yet?
Don't forget to like and subscribe.
All right, so this scripture is taken from Isaiah 41 and 10. Fear thou not, for I am with thee. Be not dismayed, for I am thy God. I will strengthen thee, yea, I will help thee. Yea, I will uphold thee with the right hand of my righteousness. That's our scripture in Bible study. We all should have gotten that one right. Yes? Yay!
Okay, as I said earlier, this month's topic is on deliverance from strongholds. So we're actually going to be discussing questions for people who probably don't understand or to kind of like dive into the whole topic. So, the speaker for tonight is going to be Ariel, who's behind me, and we're just going to be talking about questions about what is it, how can you receive it from the Lord, and how can you like actually ask for it and to get delivered. So the first question for tonight is going to be, what is deliverance?
So the dictionary of what deliverance is the act of delivering someone or something, the state of being delivered, especially liberation or rescue. So that's just the regular dictionary of what deliverance is. But for me as a believer, deliverance is, you know, we can be sometimes cumbered by so many things in this life, whether it's mental illness, anger, sadness, depression, so many other things. And when you're delivered by God, you are have freedom and peace from those things.
I really like that. That's a really good breakdown of the, you know, term deliverance.
Yeah.
And I like what you said, whether you started giving examples of what you would need deliverance from, like anger and depression. A lot of times I think we don't realize that these things are strongholds in our lives. Mm-hmm. And with these strongholds, it holds us back from being who God wants us to be. And we can't operate properly in the sense of who we're called to be and what we're called to do. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Right.
So, you know, these things are strongholds. And just a little snippet on what a stronghold is. A stronghold is, the synonym for it is to keep. So it's anything that keeps you, like holds you, and it has a restraint or possession on you. So, I mean, there's so many things that could be strongholds in our lives, and you just named a few of them.
Yeah.
Wow, that was a great way to put it. The second question is going to be, is deliverance for everybody? So can everyone possibly get delivered, or is it just like a certain way or like way of life that you have to be?
So the good thing about the God that we serve, deliverance is for everybody.
Thank you, Lord.
There is nobody like a certain population or a certain people. It is for everybody.
Yes.
Everybody has access to the throne, and that's a beautiful thing.
Yes.
About the
yes.
God that we serve.
Right, and along with that, it's for everybody, and deliverance is something that you can be delivered from anything. No, don't let anyone make you feel like you can't be delivered from this or from that. You can be delivered from anything, and it's for everybody, and that's the best part about it. You know,
amen.
God doesn't say, oh, well, no,
amen.
Only you get delivered.
Right.
Or
right.
You
right.
No, it's for everyone.
Yeah.
All
exactly.
We have to do is just tap in, and you're right there.
Yeah,
you know what
really
I love?
There.
I love that deliverance is free. Oh my God. Can you imagine?
Yeah.
Think about it. When you have sicknesses and you go to the doctors, they're charging you
mm-hmm.
based
yeah.
on your sickness.
Yeah. Right.
Now you go to the doctor for a common cold versus going to the doctor for cancer. It's a whole different
mm-hmm.
fee.
Right.
So
mm-hmm.
I love that deliverance is free. I love that it's free.
Yeah.
Right, yeah.
And there's no limit. There's no limit.
And you have to
God
want
do.
Deliverance
yes.
in order to get it. You have, even though it's free, you have to want it to get
right.
it.
Right. So tonight, the third question is going to be, what does it mean to ask for deliverance? So like, what does that mean for you to ask for it? What do you have to do, or what do you have to like be in a certain point of your life to come to ask God for deliverance?
So with asking, you know, I believe there's at least two things that are required of us when you're asking God for deliverance. You know, you're asking knowing that you have to let go and let God. Ask, and asking with a heart of expectation. So the first one, when you are letting go and letting God, it means you're giving God full control of when and where you're going to be delivered and when it's going to happen. God is an on-time God. Even when he's 4 days late, he's still on time. You know, a song based on the scripture says, those that wait on the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up like wings of an eagle. They shall run and not be weary. And they shall walk and not be faint. Teach me, Lord, how to wait. And that's taken from Isaiah 40, verse 31. And the second one, you know, when you're asking with a heart of expectation, it's important to believe that God is going to deliver you wholeheartedly. So you're saying, Lord, I trust you even though I don't see my way.
I like that because I like how you touched on that, you know, deliverance is something that when we ask for it, it's something that, you know, we're going with expectations. You know, God doesn't limit anything. You know what I'm saying? He can do anything for you. He's here for you. All you have to do is just go for him and ask him. And sometimes he doesn't even wait for you to ask. You could probably walk into a church and he does it for you unexpectedly because that's how God is. He's an on-time God. When it's your time and he's calling you, he's going to get you no matter what way.
Mm-hmm. Great.
Wow. Great. Definitely. So the fourth question will be, how do you, what does it mean to receive deliverance? So, like, it's one thing to ask for it, but like, what does it mean when you receive it, when you're actually delivered by God? So
when it comes to receiving deliverance, you're asking God to deliver you. So now is the time where you really have to live by the Spirit. So of course, always live by the Spirit, not by the flesh. But as humans, we tend to go to the default. Meaning, the very thing that God has delivered us from, we go
right
back into
it.
So we really want to
yes.
stay away from those things. And, you know, you know, in therapy called triggers, but there's so many things in this life that, you know, we're delivered from it and then we go back and pick it up again. So we really want to stay away from those things and stay away from maybe people that has dragged us, you know. Of course, be the light of this world, be the salt of this earth. However, when you are strong, do those things. So in the meantime, you know, just be totally into God's word, you know, have a mind of God. And in order to do that, you have to dive deep into his word. You know, for a lot of brothers and sisters, it's about freedom. You know, not only do you become free, there's this peace, you know, and we really want to be able to just, when we're having the mind of God and he has delivered us and we've received that, you know, you're totally free. Scripture says, for you, my brothers, we're called to freedom nature, Galatians 5, verse 13, which means once you are free, stay free. Galatians 5, verse 1 says, stand fast thereof in the liberty wherein Christ has made us free, and be not entangled again with the yoke of bondage.
I like that. I really like how you touched on when you get delivered that sometimes some people go back. The best way I've learned to prevent that is to pray and thank God. God, I thank you for my deliverance. I thank you for delivering me from so-and-so. Because after we get delivered, we sometimes go, oh yeah, you know, boom, it's gone. You know, I'm a better person now. You know, 3 months down the line, boom, you know, we're fall right back into the same thing. And temptation is something, it's never ending. Temptation is always there. So anytime you go into prayer, it's best that when you go before God, God, I forgive me of my sins, so-and-so, boom, God, thank you for deliverance. Thank you for making me a new person. Thank you for making me whole again. Thank you for cleaning my soul, making, you know, different things like that. It helps you, it just helps remind you of, you know, where God's taking you from. So I think that's it's really good that you touched on that.
I agree. And one thing is our mindset. We have to want to be free. We have to believe that we're free in order to not go back into that bondage again. We must have a mindset to want to be free and stay free.
Wow, that's great. The last question for tonight is, what does it mean to believe? So this could go many ways. You could either believe in the Lord or believe for him to deliver you, that you can't do everything by yourself. So what does that mean for you to actually like put your belief into him to deliver you?
So once you have been delivered, it's time to believe it. You know, so my brothers and sisters, walk in your freedom. Walk in the peace that God has given you. You know, this means believing that you're totally free. Not just like, oh, I'm free, but yeah, I'm still entangled by what's going on. You know, I kind of feel at peace. No, walk completely in the freedom and peace that God has given you. This means that you're no longer in bondage. There's nothing that's entangling you up. So John 8:36, and we read it earlier. So as the Son sets you free, you will be free indeed.
All right, I hope you guys enjoyed this roundtable discussion on deliverance. I hope you guys like our discussion on our different questions, on what deliverance is, which we covered, about how to receive it, how to ask it, how to believe in it. I hope when you guys go through this week, you could think about some different topics and strongholds that you guys are dealing with in your everyday life, and how you can ask for deliverance and to eventually be delivered by the Lord. So now we're just going to transition into going into Sister Kadeen and her charge for tonight.
All right, so our charge for this episode is coming from Galatians chapter 5, verse 1. And it says, stand fast, therefore, in the liberty wherewith Christ had made us free, and be not entangled again with the yoke of bondage. And what this scripture is saying to us is, if we are in Christ, Christ had set us free from bondage, we are delivered from sin, and he doesn't want us to go back to that bondage, the bad habit that we were entangled in before. He doesn't want us to be enslaved to these things. So we must have a mindset, as we said before, to want to be free and stay free. Romans chapter 6 and 12 says, therefore, do not let sin reign in your mortal body so that you obey its desire. Be careful of what you do, what you see, what you hear, how and what you feed your mind with. Those are things that we could stand guard on in order to not find ourselves back in bondage. So your charge for this episode is to find out what are some things that you may need deliverance from.
If you want to know more about this God that we are talking about that delivers, you can ask God yourself to come into your heart and to cleanse you of all of your problems and your things that you are going through. I would like to say, if you have any prayer requests or anything that you're dealing with that you want someone to pray for you about, you could comment down below and you can say all of the things that you just want someone to pray for you for. So now I'm going to end off with a prayer. Thank you, Lord, for bringing all of us together. Thank you for giving me the strength and the confidence to bring your word and tell everyone about how you can deliver others. And I wish that everyone can feel safe enough to speak to you and to have them be delivered by you, dear Lord. In Jesus' name we pray, amen.
Amen.
Okay, so you can find all of our socials at?
Well, on Facebook, The Central New Testament Church of God. The Central New Testament Church of God. On YouTube is going to be CNTCOG Church. That's, again, that's CNTCOG Church. And the last one for the church's website is cntcog.org. One more time, cntcog.org. Thank you guys so much.
Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. And leave a couple comments too.
Remember, as you go through your week, stand up! Bye!
There
you go. Loosen
up, guys.
Yeah.
They're supposed to get their Bibles or anything.
I mean, we get a lot out. I think it was the best episode. Me and I was like, yeah! And so.
So sorry.
It's okay.
Okay. Episode. Yes. For this episode. You're saying.
That's fine. That's fine. Because Jesus, he.
Oh
no, okay.
Do it again, that's okay.
I said today. That's
no.
That was okay.
Okay. Right, I'm
so YouTube ready.
Ooh,
I'm like, right?
Drop it down below. Comment next to the
moon. Don't forget to like and subscribe.
Can they start? Are you recording? Can we go?
Yes, ready?
Alright.
Wait, hold on.
Okay. YouTube ready, yeah?
Remember, as you go through your week, stand up!
Do it again! I love you, though!
Can they am I getting on that? Right now?
Please don't fall off!
That's what I was thinking. I was like, please, skirt.
Good night, everyone. Oh my gosh.
That's okay. You flow.
That's okay.
Alright.
Check. Jesus loves me, this I know. Oh, the Bible tells me to.
Nardia, yeah. What are you doing?
My check.
Did you check if the mic was just on or if it's recording? What are you doing?
We're checking if it's on.
You're recording. It's not just on, it's recording.
Hello everyone, make sure you like and subscribe. God bless you.
Still recording.
Oh, okay.
Say goodbye.